Seminargo. So today I'm doing this makeup look. This is using CoverGirl's Shimmering Sands Trio. And this whole video is inspired by Emily Noel 83. She was the first person I ever heard talk about this trio. And I believe I got this when I was in New York, or else I ordered it online, but I think I got it in New York. So I did my entire eye look with these three eyeshadows. And of course I'm going to show you guys how I do my entire face, from very bare-faced start to this full glam end. So yeah, I'll leave the link for the video that I was inspired by down below. And other than that, don't forget to thumbs up the video if you enjoyed the look and watching high definition. And without further ado, here comes the tutorial. So I'm going to start out with a redness correcting primer to even out my skin tone. I have quite a lot of redness. This one is by Makeup Forever, and it's the Step 1 Skin Equalizer. I just put these nails on yesterday, last night actually, and I just have to get used to wearing long square nails. I don't know why it's so hard for me. And to combat my under eye dryness, I'm going to use the Laura Mercier, it's not, it's the Laura Geller Speckle Under Eye Primer. And this one has a little built-in applicator, but I do prefer to use my fingers. And I know this is a little bit excessive, but I do have larger pores on my nose and this part of my cheek and on my chin. So I am going to use the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer, Pore Minimizing. But I don't need a ton of this. I only apply it on the problem areas. So for foundation today, I'm going to use the Rimmel Lasting Finish, and I use the color Ivory. And in Europe, the foundation comes with a pump. Yay! And I'm going to use my Artiste Oval 7 brush, and I'm going to spray it with my setting spray. I'm going to use this later, and just work that kind of into the bristles. And I'm using two pumps. And I think that should be the right amount. And then I'm going to blend it out with sweeping motions. And as you guys can probably tell, I have a lot of little red spots all over my neck and chest. So I'm going to use my foundation down here as well. And you guys are not gonna believe this, but I'm actually only applying this one layer of foundation. And that's because I'm going to use a powder foundation to set. So instead I'm moving on to concealer. This is the Essence Camouflage Full Coverage Concealer in the color number 05 Ivory. I have used this before, but I don't really remember what I thought of it, so I'm going to use it today. And today I'm going to do something new. I'm only going to apply my concealer on like the hollow part of my under eye. Normally I always do the triangle, but I am pretty hollow underneath my eyes, so I'm hoping by just applying my lighter concealer there, maybe I can bring that forward a bit. So I just apply it like so, and then I'm going to apply a little bit around the nose and on smile lines. And then I'm going to highlight my face. And I'm going to use my concealer brush. I'm just going to spray that. And just kind of work the setting spray into the brush. And then I go ahead and blend it out. This, so far, seems to be a really great concealer. I don't know why I haven't used this that much before. Okay, I think I'm just going to apply a little more foundation in this area, because I think it's looking a little red and not quite even. So I'm just dabbing that on and blending it out with my brush. Okay, so I think that's pretty good. So to set underneath my eyes, I'm going to use the e.l.f. Under Eye High Definition Setting Powder. And I'm going to warm up my ring finger and use this to blend out creases in my concealer. So I'm just going to look up and just lightly press underneath the eye. And then just sweep a bit of this powder underneath. For my powder foundation, I'm going to use the BA's Cosmetics Studio Pro Powder Foundations. So I have a lighter color called number 205 and a darker color called 215. So this is the lighter and this one is the darker. I'm just going to mix the two and just apply that right over the foundation. So I get nice and matte skin. and I get a little more coverage. And of course, I'm going to bring this down my neck to further disguise my little red bumps. So I'm going to use my NYX highlight and contour palette to bronze and contour. And I'm going to start with this color. And I'm just going to use this to bronze up my face. This is a matte color. And then I'm going to use the color right next to it to do my contouring. So I'm going to use my NARS Ida brush to carve out my cheekbones a little bit more. And I'm going to blend that out with my bronzer brush. And on my nose, I'm going to use my e.l.f. fan brush. And I'm going to use my powder brush to blend this out. And I'm going to run the slightest bit of this right underneath my lower lip. Right in here. And I also just blend out my cheeks with my powder brush. So I'm going to add a bit of color to my face with the Too Faced Love Flush wardrobe, sorry. And I'm going to use the color Love Hangover. You can get these blushes individually. And I'm going to apply this color up here above my bronzer and contour. And finally, I'm going to use the Makeup Revolution Pro Base Aqua Priming Base, and this is a primer, but I'm going to use it as a setting spray. Just so my face looks, you know, alive. I want my face to be matte, but I don't want it to look like the life has been sucked out of my skin, you know? So now we are going to do the eyes, and I'm going to do the brows first. And I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I have tweezed a bit of my brow off right under this arch because I feel like this brow is always drooping down compared to this one over here. So I tried to combat that by tweezing a bit of the brow away underneath the very arch. So that's why it's a little sparse over here. It's just something I'm trying out to see how it looks. So to fill in my brows today, I'm going to use the e.l.f. Eyebrow Lifter and Filler in the color Light. And I'm going to use this throughout the entire brow. So I'm going to keep it darker out here and lessen the pressure in here so it gets a bit lighter in the inner part. So on the other end of this brow pencil, there is this little highlighter that I'm going to use to clean up my brows. And it took me a little while longer to do my brows today just because I'm so used to doing my brows a particular way. But now that I tweezed this brow over here, it's a lot different and I have to do my brows differently. But anyways, I'm going to use this to clean them up. And I'm going to just blend that downwards with a Q-tip. So I still don't know what I think about these brows, but as I sit, I'm just trying it out because I have been thinking about maybe getting a little bit of Botox in this brow to give it a lift, but I don't know if I can commit to that. So instead I thought I would try other options. So I'm going to set my brows into place with my New York color, it's called the Showtime Styling Gel. And I have this one in the color Light Medium. And this is a little bit big for my brows at the moment. But I'll see if I can make it work. Now we can move on to the eyes and eyeshadows. And I'm going to prime using the Essence I Love Stage eyeshadow base. So this is going to prime my eyelids and also conceal the veins. And I'm going to try and use this concealer brush once again because I do have these long nails and I'm not sure I can blend it out with my fingers then. So the trio I'm going to use today is by CoverGirl and this is the Shimmering Sands. And I'm going to start out with the lightest color. And I'm going to pat this onto the inner half of my eyelids. And I'm also going to take it around the tear duct. Then I'm going to switch over to the darkest color And I just switched my brush around and used the other side. And this color is going on the outer half. And just blending it right here in the center with the lighter color. So I'm using the same color on a small little blending brush. And I'm going to blend that into the crease. And I kind of tilt my head back and look down into a mirror to better be able to place the color in this very inner crease part. So now I'm going to take the middle color and I'm going to use it on my MAC 224 blending brush. And I'm just going to apply it right on the border of the dark color in the crease to blend that out. And I'm doing this very softly. I just want to fade the eyeshadows out. So now I take some tissue and I wipe off my brush. And with a little bit of the lightest color, I go ahead and apply that right underneath the brow. Just right up in here. So I'm going back to the darkest color. And with my MAC angled brush, I'm going to apply this underneath my eyes. So now I'm going ahead and doing some brown liquid liner. And the one I'm going to use is by LA Colors. So I'm just doing a little cat eye and I'm also extending the inner corner. So now that I have my eyeliner on, I'm going to use the BS Cosmetics Lash Curler. And my mascara is the Essence I Love Extreme Crazy Volume Mascara. And this one is not waterproof, so I'm going to apply a waterproof top coat on top. Oh, I really like this mascara. I kind of forget how good it is. So I'm just going to apply my second coat because I want nice big lashes. So my waterproof mascara top coat is the Keep 'Em Dry by W7. And I'm just going to give my lashes a coat of this to prevent it from smearing. And this is of course totally optional. This is only because I need it. If you don't need it, just skip it. So in my waterline, I'm going to use MAC Fascinating Eye Kohl. So for falsies, I'm going to use these cat eye shaped ones by W7. These are in the style HL04. So I'm using my W7 lash glue. I was going to use my duo glue, but that is packed away in my suitcase because I'm going to Poland in 2 days on Monday. Today it is Saturday. I don't know when this video will go up. But yeah, I'm really excited. It's my first time going to Poland. So I'm going for a week to Gdansk from Monday to Monday with my dad, and we are just going to do some touristy things. Anyways, I'm going to apply this lash. Okay, so now that I have my lashes on, I can finish off the eyes with a bit more mascara and eyeliner. So I'm going to go over the lash band. And I'm just going to keep looking down until that is dry. Then I apply a tiny bit more mascara to my top lashes. And then of course also to the bottom, where I'm going to apply two coats of mascara and then a coat of top coat. Okay, so now I'm going to do my lips. And I'm going to start out with MAC Strip Down Lip Liner. And I'm going to slightly overline my lips with this color. And for a liquid lipstick, I'm going to use the Kiss Celeste matte liquid lipstick in the color Nude Cameo. And I have only swatched this before, I have never actually used it. So I don't know what I think about this color. Okay, so I still don't know what I think about this lipstick. On one hand, I kind of like the color. and it feels really lightweight on my lips. It feels like I have nothing on. But on the other hand, it looks a little bit chalky, and also it like settles into every single little line on my lips. Like, I didn't even know I had lip wrinkles, but I do now. It's not noticeable unless you're up close and personal and I smile or stretch out my lips or something. So I don't know, still on the fence about this Kiss liquid lipstick. But anyways, enough about that lipstick. This is the finished look. So if you have the CoverGirl Shimmering Sands Trio, I hope this gave you some inspiration for a look you could do with it. So as always, don't forget to thumbs up this video if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in my next video, so take care and bye bye!